Hello students, and welcome to another video. I'm your teacher, Mr. Flynn, and today we're going to be talking about significant figures. Okay, and the definition for significant figures, okay, I'm just going to put it down there. I don't want to write it again. It is the number of digits that contributes toward accuracy. Now, let's think about what accuracy means. Accuracy refers to how close you are to hitting your aim. If you are at a gun range or you're shooting arrows, you have a target and you're trying to get as close to the bullseye as possible, or a different part of the target, but whatever your desire is, where you're wanting to aim, you're going to that is how close you are to hitting that is considered your accuracy. When you're in the lab and you're making measurements and you're using a ruler like this one, okay, you can gain a lot of accuracy for centimeters because there's a lot of lines on this. Okay, while, let me go grab a beaker real quick. Show you these. If you look at this beaker, okay, there's lines that are about every 50 or so. And then this one we have every one's place, plus or minus one, right there. Okay, so between these beaker and this graduated cylinder is gonna be much more accurate, okay? And using centimeters will be more accurate than inches because those lines are a lot closer together. We can get closer inside that space, okay? Now, when we work in the lab, we make measurements and we have values that are given to us. But what happens if we're given data and we don't know what instruments they used? We don't know where that number came from, etc. Okay, the way we do that is by following four rules. Okay, and they're the significant figures rule. So the first rule is all non-zero digits and any zeros contained between are considered significant. Okay, all non-digit zeros and any zeros contained between. So for example, we have the number 5,402. All right, how many significant figures are in this number? I would say there's four sig figs. I'm gonna call them sig figs for short. Okay, sig figs. And I'm gonna underline the sig fig portion, okay? Because all non-zero digits, so if it's anything but zero, it's gonna be significant. So there's three of them, but we're also gonna count the zeros in between them. So this one's locked in between two non-zeros. So that's considered to have four significant figures. Okay, let's do another example of this. What if I had 60,302? Okay, so I have zeros that are locked in between these significant numbers, so there's going to be five sig figs in this number. Pretty simple. If a zero is in between two zero digits, it's going to be significant. Two. Okay. Leading zeros don't count. These are shortened. Okay. Leading zeros don't count. They're not significant. Now let me give you an example. If we have 0.000563 as our measurement, there is only three sig figs. Three sig figs. All right, let's do another one. We have 0.0603. Okay, we have two non-zero digits, and then we have one that's trapped inside, but these zeros don't count. So the only significant figures are these three. Okay. Okay. If you're struggling with the idea of, well, why is it significant? I want you to bear with me, okay, as we keep going. There's two more rules. And as I start to summarize it, and as we work in the lab and do these problems, it's going to make more sense to you over time. So if you're feeling a little confused, it's okay. But as long as you understand these rules, and when you look at a number and what's considered significant, it will gradually come to you about, oh, that's showing you how accurate that equipment is. Okay. Like, for example, if I were to look at this periodic table, this one is not as accurate as the one on my wall. So for example, carbon on this table is 12.01. But if I look up on my wall, it's 12.0108. Okay. If you look at these two numbers, which one's more accurate? Which one has more information? The one on my wall does. It has a much bigger number. It's got more significant figures, while carbon's a much simpler number. So if I'm working in the lab and I'm doing calculations, would it be useful for me to use this big number or the little bit smaller number that's close? You know, this number is so accurate, it's hard to use in the lab because it's too specific. It's too broad, it's too sharp of a scalpel. Okay, we need something that's a little more blunt because the stuff we use is a little bit more blunt of an instrument. Okay, we don't have equipment that's millions of dollars that gets us to this degree of accuracy. So 12.101 suffices. That's why I rounded all these numbers to the hundredths place and not to the 10,000th place. Okay, I should just I'll erase that off later. Okay, all right, let's keep going. So three. Trailing zeros. Count if there is a decimal. Okay, so for example, I have 0.032 00. Okay, now compared to this one above, I'm off the screen. Sorry about that. I'm meaning to pause it. If you look above, this zero is trapped in between two non-zero digits. But here we have trailing zeros behind this three and this two. We would actually count these ones because they're trailing. Okay, and that's because there is a decimal there. If there's no decimal, it'd be different. Okay, so in this example, we have 4 sig figs. All right. The next one I'll do is 15.00. Okay, that's a period there, another decimal there. Because they're trailing and there is a decimal there, these all count. So it's going to be 4 sig figs. All right. Now let's do the last rule. I'm going to move this down a little bit. 4 sig figs. I'm sorry, not 4 sig figs. These are both 4 sig figs. But rule number 4 is trailing zeros do not count if there is no decimal. All right. So for example, if I had 21,000, there's only 2 sig figs there. Okay. There's only 2. Now, if I had a decimal right here, I would have 5. In this measurement, it only goes to here. Let's do one more. 31.08. Right. In this number, there's no trailing zero. There's one that's trapped. That's on rule 1. So it's going to have 4 sig figs. Okay. All right. That's all the rules. That's all you got to know. When you do measure in the lab, like if you measure the length of a line, right, you would have a degree of accuracy and you would be basically following the rules of significant figures. But if you haven't measured it and you want to know how accurate a number is, you will need to know the rules for significant figures. Because when you start doing math and you start combining or multiplying different degrees of accuracy, it's going to influence how overall accurate your number is going to be, right? So if you use a very accurate number with a number that's not as accurate, the number that's not as accurate is going to influence the outcome of that problem. So you actually, there's rules to follow when you do addition and multiplication and such. So I will teach you those later, but this is just to break down and understand what numbers are considered significant, because it relates to how accurate that number is. Okay, are you using centimeters or are you measuring in meters, right? It depends on what you're measuring and what is useful to your measure, to what you're measuring. Okay, thanks again for watching. Until next time.